Sa video natin ngayon, let's learn how to analyze parabolic arches and also how to analyze the internal loadings if we have a specified point of interest. So we have the following problem. This is a parabolic arc, symmetrical siya, and then we have the following loads, 50 kN, 60 kN, and 50 kN, all acting vertically. Then we have point M, this is our point of interest. Yan. Now, this is statically determinate since meron tayong tatlong reactions. We have one reaction para sa hinge. I mean, two reactions pala. We have AY saka AX. And then, at this point naman, sabi natin this is point C. Lagyan ko na lang AB saka C. So, we have here CY. Yan. So, to solve AY, I can sum up moments about point C equal to 0. So, we have AY, then the moment arm is this whole distance, which is 16 yan, pag i-add mo lahat. Then, we have 50 kilonewtons. This will cause a counterclockwise rotation about point C. So, minus 50, then multiplied by this moment arm, which is 15 meters. And then minus 60, then the moment arm is 4 plus 5, 9 plus 3, magiging 12. Then finally, we have 50 kilonewtons, counterclockwise pa rin yung rotation, then multiplied by 3 meters. Yan. So, set to 0, makukuha natin yung AY. So, AY is 101.25. Yan. Kapag isosolve nyo. And then, if AY is 101.25, then makukuha na natin yung CY by summing up forces along Y. So, we have AY plus CY minus lahat ng downward loads na to. So, minus 50, minus 60, then minus another 50. Set to 0, we have AY is known. This is 101.25. So, CY equals, gawin mong positive yan lahat, move mo sa kabilang side ng equation, then ito magiging minus. So, the result of CY would be 58.75. This is kilonewtons. Ayan, so nasolve na natin yung AY saka CY. And then yung AX, medyo madali lang kasi wala namang horizontal forces na nag-act. So summation of forces along the X-axis, AX will just be equal to 0. Ayan, so medyo madali lang. Now, nakuha na natin yung external reactions. But meron tayong tie rod connecting A to C. So, this is a tie rod which will carry tension. Now, para ma-solve natin yung internal force na yan, and also to account for the force acting sa internal hinge at B, let's try to make a cut that will include the two. Yan. So, parang ma-isolate yung member natin. Dalawang members kasi yan. One member and another member separated by an internal hinge. Yan. So, maglalabasan na yung internal forces. Sa tie rod, may lalabas na tensile forces. And then sa point B, lalabas yung vertical and horizontal reactions sa internal hinge. So, essentially, making this cut, ito yung mangyayari. Yan. Let's just consider the left side since the point of interest M is nasa left side kasi ng cut. So, ito na yung lalabas na figure. So, AY is 101.25. AX is 0. Yan. And then, isosolve pa natin yung BY saka BX. As well as T. Yan. So, first kong gagawin, magsasum up lang ako ng forces along Y. Ito kasi yung pinakamadali. So, I have... Excuse me. So, I have AY Then, minus 50. Ito. Tapos, minus 60. Plus ko yung BY. Yan. Set ko to 0. But again, AY is known. 101.25. So, solving BY, we have, ano ba yan? Negative 101.25 plus 110. Yan, so 8.75 pala. Then, positive yung lumabas, meaning tama yung assumption ko na BY is acting upward. So, lagyan ko na lang din ng direction. Yan, para sure talaga. And then, to solve T naman, ito, we can sum up moments sa point B. So, summation of moments about point B, we have 101.25, clockwise yung rotation niya na makukos, and then the moment arm is 8 meters, yung buong distance na yan. Then, we have minus 50, this one, the moment arm going to point B is 7 meters. So, minus 50 times 7. Yan. And then, 60 kilonewtons, counterclockwise pa rin yung rotation, moment arm is 4. So, minus 60 multiplied by 4. Then, we have T. Makukos niya na rotation is counterclockwise. So, minus T, then, ano yung moment arm niya? The moment arm is the height of the parabolic arc, which is, ano nga yun? 6, diba? Pasensya, hindi ko nasulat. Yan, 6 meters. Set to 0, makukuha na natin yung T. So, T is equal to, solve natin na. 101.25 times 8 minus 50 times 7 minus 60 times 4 minus x multiplied by 6. Set to 0, we have 36.67 approximately. This is kilonewtons. Sige, so before natin isosolve yung internal internal moment saka internal forces, let's try to analyze the figure. Yan. And then let's look at how we can apply the concept of parabolas para sa problem natin. Now, ito yung concept dyan. The vertex of the arc would be right here at the location of the internal hinge since na-separate yung members dyan. And then, the concavity kasi is always upward or downward para sa parabolic arcs. So, hindi pwede na andito yung vertex mo. Always yan nandito. Kasi pag i-extend mo yan, parang ganito. Concavity is downward. Sige, so, if this is the vertex, then I can draw a horizontal line from the vertex patungo sa endpoint na to. Then, draw din tayo ng vertical line. Ayan. Notice na itong figure na to, yan. Diba, this is a spandrel. So, sa previous discussions natin, kapag meron kang spandrel, then you can apply the squared property of a parabola. Yan. Kapag second degree. This is to the second degree kasi. Yan. So, we can draw a line from the point of interest patungo dito. Yan. So, ano yung squared property property ng parabola? Of a parabola. Yan. Diba, this is y divided by x squared. Ito yung gagamitin natin na ratio and proportion. So, let's try to consider first the whole spandrel. So, for the whole spandrel, the height is 6. Diba? 6 meters man yan. So we would have here 6 divided by the horizontal distance. The horizontal distance is 8. So 6 is 2, 8 squared equals, sabihin natin this is y1. Now y1 is to what horizontal distance? Baka sabihin mo 1. Mali yan, kasi again, all distances of x are measured from the vertex. So this is the vertex. Lagay ko na lang ah. So going to this point, we have a distance of 4 plus 3. So 7 pala dapat. 7 squared. And so y1 is 6 times, 7 squared times 6 divided by 8 squared. So 147 over 32 or 4.59375. This is meter. Now, what we want is this distance para sa moment. Kasi yan yung magiging moment arm ng T patungo sa point na to. So, this distance, yan, ililabel ko as y. Now, to get y, we have to subtract y1 from 6. So, y equals 6 minus y1. So, 6 minus 4.59375, ano yan? 6 minus answer. We have 1.40625. And then this is in meter. Yan. Now, meron actually tayong shortcut para sa value ng y. So, ito yung pwede nyong gamitin. Shortcut for y. Yan. Again na, this is the height patungo sa point of interest. So, the shortcut is y equals 4hx times l minus x then divided by l squared. Now, define natin yung variables. Ano yung h? H is the height of the parabolic arc. X naman is the distance from the left patungo sa point of interest. So, ito yung left, left end, patungo sa point of interest, the distance is 1. So, yan pala yung x. Yan. Lagay ko na lang ah. This is x. And then, yung l naman, sa variable natin, yan yung total distance ng parabolic arc. So, let's try substituting the values. We have y equals 4 times h. Ano yung h? H is 6. Yan. And then L is the total length, which is 16. Pag i-add mo yan lahat. Then minus X, which is 1. Tapos divided by L squared. So, 16 squared. Now, try down natin. Kailangan mag-equal siya sa 1.40625. Kasi yan yung na-solve natin using the concept of parabolas talaga. Now, 4 times 6 times 16 minus 1 divided by 16 squared, we have 45 divided by 32, which is 1.40625 lang din. This is meter. So, notice na the same lang. Yan. But again, yung advantage, if alam mo yung concept, then no need to memorize this one. But if you're comfortable memorizing formulas and then magaling kang mag-memorize talaga, then pwede rin. Again, depende yan sa preference mo. But I would, ako, personal preference ko is ito. Yung sa ratio and proportion lang talaga. Sige, so let's proceed. Alam na natin na this is 1.40625. So, nilagay ko na lang dyan. Now, ito yung dapat niyong tandaan. Kapag merong concentrated load, diba sa mechanics of deformable bodies, sinabi natin na kapag merong concentrated load at a certain point, then we would have left and right shear values. The same lang dito. Notice na sa point M, meron tayong 50K and load, concentrated. So, meron pala tayong loadings before point M or before na-apply yung 50K and load and after na-apply yung 50 kN load. So, yung first values natin para sa normal force, shear force, yan would be before the concentrated load. So, kaya sa figure natin, wala pa yung 50 kN load. Yan, kinat na kasi natin siya. So, itong NM, yan yung normal thrust. Nagay ko na lang ah. Normal thrust, and then VM naman, this is the radial shear. Radial shear force. Now, the normal thrust force is acting normal or perpendicular to the cross-section. Yan. And then the radial shear force naman, alam natin na shear force is acting parallel to the cross-section. Kaya this is parallel. Yan, yung V. And then, M sub M, yan yung moment. Internal moment. So, it would be best na mag-assume tayo ng values that would act sa negative direction para sa variables natin. MM, NM, saka VM. Now, notice na lahat ng forces natin nag-a-act sa rotated axis. This one. Rotated axis, saka ito. Yan. Notice that this is a tangent line. This one. Tangent line yan sa point of interest natin. So, sir, paano nakuha yung angle na yan? 52.696. Let's go back sa definition ng slope. Slope of a tangent line. So, balik tayo dito. Ah. Yan, copy ko to. And then, let's draw a tangent line sa point na to. So, we would have this one. Yan, this is a tangent line. So, we can draw a horizontal line sa point na to. And then, we would have a certain angle here. Yan, yan yung theta na isosolve natin. Now, the equation of a parabola is, diba, recall natin, y equals kx squared. Now, differentiating this, makukuha natin yung slope, dy over dx. So, this is magiging 2kx applying the power rule. So, 2, multiply mo, mo lang yan dyan. And then, bawas ng 1 sa exponent, magiging 2kx na siya. Now, to solve k, we can use the boundary conditions. Or essentially, yung pinakamadaling x distance and y distance na matutukoy mo. Now, yung pinakamadali dyan is, diba, alam natin this is 6. Yung height ng parabola. This is 6 meters. And then the horizontal distance from the vertex would be 8 meters. So, at x equals 8, the height of the parabola is 6. Therefore, using this function, substitute ko lang yung y saka x. So, we would have we would have 6 equals k times 8 squared. Yan. Substituting y and x. So, k is equal to 6 divided by 8 squared. So, ano yan? 6 divided by 8 squared. We have 3 divided by 32. So, ito na yung k natin. We can now solve dy over dx. So, dy over dx would be 2 times 3 divided by 32. Now, ano yung x? X must be measured still from the vertex. So, ito yung vertex. This distance is 7 meters. 4 plus 3. So, multiplied by 7. Yan, para makuha mo yung slope ng tangent line sa point na to. So, we have 2 times 3 divided by 32 multiplied by 7, which is 21 divided by 16. Move ko lang to. Ah. 21 over 16. Now, since yung kailangan natin is angle para sa calculations natin sa rotated axis, then to get the angle, para kasi yung merong triangle yan dyan, na dy over dx, yan yung slope ng tangent line. So, we can use the tangent function, yan, since this is opposite, while this is adjacent to the reference angle. So, tangent of theta equals dy over dx, which is 21, divided by 16. Yang value na yan. Now, taking the arctangent sa dalawang sides, then theta would be equal to arctan 21 divided by 16. This is 52.696. Yan. And then this is in degrees. So, ganito lang yung solution natin para sa angle. But again, meron din tayong derived formula para dito. So the derived formula, or sabihin na lang natin na shortcut, ito yung gagawin natin. Theta equals arctangent of 4h divided by l squared tapos multiplied by l minus 2x. Now, the same lang kanina, l is the total length of the parabolic arc, while x is the distance from the left to the point of interest. So, again na, itong x, sinabi kong from the left kasi kapag, let's say, andito ka na sa kabilang side, pwede mo yung i-mirror. So, kapag i-mirror mo yan, parang yung distance x would be measured from the roller support patungo sa point of interest. So, para ma-clear talaga, let's say, I will consider BC. Remember BC. Yan. Kapag i-mirror ko siya, ito na yung figure ko. Yan. This would be C. This would be B. Then, mayroong reaction yung ruler ko dyan. Ayan. So, let's say, I want to analyze this point. So, yung magiging X ko would be this distance. Let's say, itong point na to ba? So, from the roller support, we have 3 meters. Yan. So, ito yung magiging x mo sa formula. Yan lang yung medyo tricky dyan. Kapag nasa right side ka na ng internal hinge, i-mirror mo lang yung figure para ma-apply mo yung formula. But again na, no need yung formula kapag alam mo yung derivation or alam mo yung concept talaga. Kahit yung basics lang. So, try down natin. Solve natin yung theta. This would be arctangent of 4 times height is 6. Yan, height. Then, divided by L squared. Total length is 16. So, 16 squared times 16 minus 2 multiplied by 1 meter. Diba? Kasi yan yung x. From the left to the point of interest. So, arctangent, and then 4 times 6 divided by 16 squared, then multiplied by 16 minus 2 times 1. Yan. So, 52.696 lang din. And so, notice na the same lang talaga. Itong value na to, saka ito rin. Again, depende na yan sa preference mo kung ano yung mas gusto mong way. Whether mag-memorize or gumamit ng concept. So again, we have the first values for the configuration before the concentrated load. So kaya again, walang 50 dyan. Now, una natin kukunin is yung moment lang. M sub M. Now, for M sub M, we have to sum up moments about point M equal to 0. Now, yung inassume ko na direction ko dyan is counterclockwise. Mas maganda talaga kapag negative yung assumption mo para automatic ka na mag-equate. So, we have negative MM. Yan, ito, counterclockwise. Then, kapag mag-moment tayo sa point na yan, then we have AY. So, this will cause a clockwise rotation about this point. So, plus 101.25. Then, the moment arm is 1 meter. Yan, diba? And then, we have T. This will cause a counterclockwise rotation about point M. So, minus 36.67. Then, the moment arm is 1.40625. Yung distance na yan. That's why, kinuha natin yung Y kanina. So, 1.40625. Set to 0, M sub M will be equal to, input ko na lang, 101.25 times 1, then minus 36.67 times 1.40625 equals 49.68. And then this is kilonewton meter. Ayan. Now, ito yung medyo mahirap. Paano i-solve yung NM saka VM? Para sa NM, it would be helpful na mag-sum up tayo ng forces sa rotated axis. Kasi diba, this is the tangent line. By the way ha, itong kinuha natin kanina was the slope of the tangent line, diba? So, yung slope na yan, ito, yung line na to, parallel to this one, dyan tayo magsasum up ng forces para sa normal force or the force perpendicular to the cross-section. So, itong axis na to, label ko as x prime. For a while, ah. Yan, label ko to as x prime. And then, ito naman, label ko as y prime. Saka ito rin, x prime, saka y prime. Now, the angle theta is with respect to the horizontal from the line parallel to the tangent. So, ito yung theta. This is also theta. Now, need natin i-component yung AY saka T. Kasi diba, this is acting horizontally while this is acting vertically. So, need pa natin yan siyang i-component along the rotated axis, y prime and x prime. Now, let's first analyze kung ano yung angle theta. Now, kapag theta yan, ano yung magiging angle na to? Yan. Sa tingin nyo, I hope you would agree na this angle would be 90 minus theta. Bakit? This is perpendicular kasi y prime is an axis perpendicular to x prime. So kapag perpendicular yan, and then this is theta, then this would be 90 minus theta since the total of these angles would be must be equal to 90. Ayan, I hope clear lang. Now, if this is 90 minus theta, ano yung angle na to? Yan, ano yung angle na yan? This angle would be theta. Kasi this is the horizontal line. This is the vertical line. So, this is also perpendicular. Diba? So, this angle pala, dito ko na lang isusulat. This is theta lang din. Iba na lang natin yung kulay. Ito na lang. Yan, theta yan. And then, always yan, na yung original force, that would be the hypotenuse. Once mag-component ka. sa new axis na perpendicular to each other. So this is our original force. Let's draw a line perpendicular sa line na to, y prime. Dito ko na lang isusulat. Ayan. So this is perpendicular. Ayan. So AY is the hypotenuse of this triangle. Diba? Now, sa rotated axis, yung component ng AY would be acting to the right and upward. Tingnan nyo. Kapag ito yung axis natin, then meron siyang component na pa right and pa upward. Now, I hope naintindihan lang. So, parang ito yan. Wait lang. Ibang kulay naman. And parang ito yung components ng AY. So, sabihin natin, this is AY prime na lang. And then, this is AY X prime. I hope naintindihan na. Yung component niya, kapag gusto mo siyang maintindihan talaga, pwede mo namang i-rotate yung axis. So, let's say, yung X prime and Y prime, gawin kong vertical and horizontal axis. Y prime, X prime. Ayan. Now, AY is acting dito. Yan. So, parang ito yan siya kapag nirotate natin. Wait lang. Hindi siya mas straight. Yan. Parang ito yung AY. And then, this is theta. Naintindihan na ba? Papakita ko na lang ah. Kapag i-rotate natin yan, para siyang magiging ganito. Yan. O, diba? Same lang. O. Yan yung consideration natin. Ilalagay ko na lang dyan sa gilid. So, para-right yung AY X prime. And then, AY prime is patungo sa up. It's going upward. And then, let's try to check yung T naman. So, for T, this is the angle theta. So, medyo madali lang siyang i-identify. So, gagawin ko, para makita nyo yung triangle, i-extend ko na lang to. Yung axis na to. And then, let me draw a line perpendicular to that. Yan, perpendicular yan. So, this is angle theta. Yan. This is the opposite side. Ito naman yung adjacent. Now, yung component ng T sa rotated axis is going to the right and going upward. Nakita niyo lang ba? Parang ito yung component niya. Parang ito yung TX prime, tapos ito naman yung TY prime. Wait lang. Sorry. Mali yung label ko. Wait lang. TY prime is going downward pala. Yes, downward. TY prime. Yan. Para maintindihan nyo, let's try to draw the X prime and Y prime axes as a vertical and horizontal axis. So, X prime, Y prime. Then, yung T is acting dito. So, parang andito yan siya. So, this is T. Yan. And then, if this is T, this would be the angle theta. Yan. So, para makita nyo, again ha, meron tayong components na essentially to the right and acting downward para sa T. So, tingnan nyo. Kapag i-rotate ko siya, Yan. Parang ito yung T. Medyo pangit lang yung drawing ko. Wait lang. Susundin ko na lang yung inclination niya. So parang ito. So this is T. And then gawin kong ganyan. Ah, this is X prime. We have here Y prime. Yan. This is theta. So again na, kapag i-rotate mo yan, extend ko lang to. Ayan. Oh, rotate mo, makukuha mo yung original figure. So again na, no need na to, pinakita ko lang talaga kasi medyo maraming students na ito yung usual question talaga. Kasi once nag-quiz na, minsan nakakalimutan yung kung paano i-resolve yung components. So importante na alam nyo yung rotation of axes. Yan. Meron naman to sa dynamics nyo. Sige, so medyo natagalan tayo dun. So let's sum up forces along X prime para makuha natin yung N sub M. So we have N sub M going to the left. So minus. Yan. And then AY X prime is going to the right. So plus. And then AY X prime is 101.25 AY, tapos i-component natin siya sa axis na to. So it would be this component. Yan, AY X prime. Or parang ito lang sa triangle natin. Now this side is opposite to the reference angle. So we have to use sine theta pala. So sine theta. Ayan. And then, for Tx naman, component niya along X prime is also going to the right. Diba? Na-clarify naman natin yan kanina. So, plus Tx, then, iba na, hindi na sine. Bakit? Sa triangle na to, yan, notice that this is my angle theta, this is the side adjacent to it. So, cosine pala. Cosine theta equals 0. Wag na lang Tx. T pala. T cos theta. So, we have here Nm. I-isolate mo lang siya sa kabilang side ng equation. Then, 101.25 sine of, ano nga yung theta? 52.696. Then, T is 36.67. Tapos, cosine. Cosine theta. 52.696. Equals, yan. So we have 102.76. This is kilonewtons. Tapos sa radial shear naman, we have to sum up forces along Y prime. So set ko yan to 0. Sige, so summation of forces along Y prime, let me treat downward as my negative direction. Yan. So this is actually going downward, yung VM. So negative VM, and then dito tayo sa AY, component niya along Y prime is acting upward. So plus 101.25, and then cosine na. Cosine, since this side is adjacent sa angle natin. Cosine 52.696. Ayan. And then, yung ty natin, ty prime, is acting downward. Diba? Sa rotated axis natin. So, minus pala. Minus 36.67. Then, we have to use sine na. Since this side is opposite to the angle. Sine 52.696. So this would be 32.193 kilonewtons. Ayan. 32.193. Sige. Now, para madali na lang yung second configuration natin, kung saan meron ng 50kN load, gagawin ko is, yan. Magde-derive na lang tayo ng equation na flexible. So, para sa NM, sige, ito na lang yung gagawin ko. Para sa NM, di ba, this is a vertical force. 101.25 is defined by AY. So, let's say, NM is equal to the vertical force sine theta. Yan. Then plus the horizontal force T, or H na lang, horizontal force, and then cosine theta. So vertical force sine theta plus horizontal force cosine theta. Ito na lang yung gagawin natin. Now, this is yung convention natin is positive yung V and H if going to the right. If going to the right, and positive if going upward para sa vertical force. So this is a horizontal force. This is a vertical force. Now, if the load is going to the left, then this would be negative. So para flexible talaga yung formula, lalagyan ko na lang ng plus minus. Ito rin, plus minus. So, plus, kapag ito yung direction, negative otherwise. Yan lang. Sige, so, sa VM naman tayo. Sa VM, isolate ko siya sa kabilang side ng equation, and then, equate ko siya dito. So I have still plus minus, plus minus. Then we have the vertical force V cosine, cosine theta, and then plus minus ulit, plus minus. Then we have horizontal force sine theta. Yan. Sige, so ito na yung formulas na gagamitin natin. So yung values natin after the concentrated load, notice na meron ng 50 kilonewtons dyan. So applying this one, again ha, yung moment hindi mag-change. Always yan, 49.68. So hindi na lang natin tatanggalin. Hindi natin isosolve ulit pala. So we have NM, N sub M, plus minus V sine theta. Sige, so tingnan daw natin yung vertical forces. Yung vertical forces natin are 101.25 acting upward. So positive, diba, sa convention natin. But then notice, 50 kilonewtons is acting downward. So we have to use minus 50. Yan, i-join na lang natin sila since ma-distribute lang sila sa sine theta. So times sine theta, or essentially sine 52.696 na lang agad. Yan. And then plus minus h cos theta. So our horizontal force is acting to the right. Yan. So according to our conventions, we have to use plus lang din. So plus t, which is 36.67, then gagamitin natin cosine theta. Ano yung theta? Theta is, saan na yun? 52.696 pala. Sige, so sum up daw natin. 101.25 minus 50, then sine of 52.696 plus 36.67 cosine of 52.96. So we have 62.85. Tama lang ba yung inputs? 696 pala dito. So 62.989 or approximately 63 kilonewtons. Ayan. And then for VM naman, we have V cos theta. Copy lang natin to. Ito naman yung V natin. And then cosine 52.696. Tapos plus or minus. Plus kasi pa-right yung force natin. 36.67 then sine 52.696. Ayan. Wait lang ha. Kanina sa VM, this was minus. Ito pala. Wait lang. May babaguhin ako sa conventions natin ha. Sa VM. Iba pala. Minus kasi kapag to the right yung force. So sa VM, still the same, upward is plus. Yan. But para sa H, horizontal force, minus yung to the right. Wait lang. Iba pala yung nakopy ko. Ito yung minus. Minus yung to the right, but for the vertical force, ito pa rin. So, kulayan ko na lang. Ito yung naka-yellow. Yan. Tapos yung VM, naka-pink. Ito yung conventions. Yan. Corresponding conventions. Sige, so, for VM pala, minus kapag to the right yung H. So, kailangan minus to. Sige. I think yan lang. So, equals, palitan na lang natin. This would be cosine dapat. Cosine and then magiging minus na to. Then, this is sine instead of cosine. So, equals 1.89. 1.89 kilonewtons. Ayan. Sige, so, again ha, nung undergrad pa ako, hindi ko ginagamit yung conventions na to. Kasi always ako nagsusolve ng using the figure lang talaga. And, pero kapag gusto mong streamline, kasi mas maganda kasi sa exam or sa quiz, meron kang faster way to solve. Pwede mong gamitin to. Yan, para automatic na. But again, you have to be extra careful sa conventions. Yan, nagkamali nga ako sa sign na to. But again, this was derived using one of the equations na ginamit natin. Sige. Now, in the case na merong distributed load, mangyayari lang is the total vertical force would be the reaction then minus the resultant of the load. Parang yan lang yung parang bago kapag meron kang distributed load. But essentially, the analysis is still the same. Sige, so ito lang yung first example natin. And then our next example naman would entail parabolic arcs na hindi symmetrical. Ito. And then we have to calculate the internal loadings sa point M. Which is maganda kasi nasa right side na siya ng internal hinge. Medyo magbabago na yung orientation. But again, pwede natin tong i-mirror kapag gusto nyo. Na kapag gusto nyo na same lang yung calculations natin sa dito. Sige, so I hope may natutunan kayo ngayon. Salamat sa pakikinig.